Welcome to the video. My name's Alex and this video is going to be my tips on how to start a small business. Well, we're going to start from the very beginning here, and that is how to come up with a business idea. If you already have your business idea, you can skip forward to the next step. This one is for people who you know you want to start a business. Maybe you want to start a side business, maybe you want to do something creative, but you don't know exactly what to do. So how do you figure out what to do? Brainstorm the things that you're interested in and the things that you're good at. And what you want to get from that list is an idea of where those two things meet. And once you come up with a list of ideas of things that you could possibly do, then you can look into the viability of that business idea in the market. Are there people that are going to want to give you money for that service? Other people might want to approach starting a business as it doesn't necessarily need to be something that you're interested in. It might be something that you just want to make good money off, and that's fine too. Because one of the tips that I picked up from a business writer, his name's Cal Newport. One of the ideas in his books, I will link it below, is that to love your career, it doesn't necessarily have to be something that you start off being passionate about. He says that often passion comes when you develop autonomy in your role, so that's having sole responsibility for something, and when you develop expertise in your role, so when you've done it for long enough that you're like an expert in your field. So you don't necessarily need to think, what are my passions? How can I turn that into a career? It doesn't have to be like that. You could just be looking into the things that make people money if that's what you want to do. On the other hand, you might want to start a business just as like a hobby business, as an outlet for something that you enjoy doing, like a creative outlet. So you already know that you want to turn that into a business. One of the surprising things for me about starting my business is how much enjoyment I actually get from the business side of things, from like handling the marketing, handling the accounts and finances, from just communicating with customers via email and handling that admin stuff. I actually get quite a lot of enjoyment out of that, but that's not why I started my businesses. And just another little tip on that is, if you start off on one business avenue, don't be afraid to change. You might start off on one avenue and then find out that you don't enjoy doing that as a business, or that you don't have any buyers no matter what you try, or that you're interested in something else, or that your customers are sort of leading you in a different direction by asking you to create a different product. I'll talk more about that in a second. So what I'm saying is, when you're trying to come up with a business idea, don't be so afraid that it has to be perfect to begin with. You can just give something a go, and it's okay to change your mind. When I first started my business back in 2013 with my wedding favors, I actually didn't start out doing wedding favors. I started out making children's party bags. I went to a party fair, and I took some photos of these different things that I saw, and one of them was mini jam favors. And I put these photos up on my Facebook just to show what I saw at the fair. And someone saw the picture of the mini jams and thought that I had made them and asked me for an order. And I was like, oh, well, I don't really do those, but I just kind of pretended that I did. And I started that, and I ended up making quite a good bit of change from that business. So you can't be afraid to like adapt. My next tip for you for starting a small business, or starting any business really, is just to start. Don't feel like you have to have everything perfect before you start. I know it can be tempting to want to have your website finished, your business cards printed, your email signature perfect, your packaging options just right, but my advice to you is, don't try and get that stuff sorted all at the beginning. Just start. Even if you only have a Facebook page to begin with, or you only have a website and you don't have the social channels, Just start. Just start with something and develop as you go. So the reason I say this is, well, first of all, if you wait until everything, you have everything perfectly ready to go before you start, you're gonna delay starting by so long and you're just gonna procrastinate and battery died. You'll procrastinate and you'll just seriously delay starting your business. So with all those things that go along with your business, like the email communication, the packaging, if that's relevant to your business, anything really that goes along with your business, you're going to figure that out as you go. So you're not gonna know at the beginning exactly what you need. You will figure it out as you go. Like you'll figure out, oh, that courier or that way of sending my product doesn't work because the product gets squashed in the mail. Or so you'll have to figure out a different way to do it. And also keep in mind that you will make mistakes. You'll do things wrong. There'll be failures. There'll be things that don't get sent properly. There'll be mistakes. There'll be awkward customer service moments. Don't be afraid of those mistakes. Expect them and just take them as learning curves and ways to perfect and improve your business. My next tip for you when you're starting out your business is to take a little bit of time to fake it till you make it. This is going to depend on what type of business you have, but for example, you might like to do some complimentary work for your friends or contacts in order to, firstly, it helps you perfect your craft and hone in the way that you're presenting either what you're selling or your service. You can ask your friends and contacts for testimonials that you can then put on your website or your social media pages. Another thing that you can do is to fake make some orders. So for example, when I was starting out my jam favor business, I didn't have a lot of orders to begin with because I had nothing to show for what I'd done. So I made some pretend favors with people's like bride and groom names on them, and I took photos of them and I posted them on social media and I said things like, congratulations to, you know, Fred and Wilma on your wedding, and pretended that I'd made this for a wedding to show people that I was in business. And then from there, the actual orders started coming in and I didn't have to do those fake products anymore. Now, I'm not saying this to be deceptive, but if you have a product to show, you need to show it, right? You can't just expect people to buy into your business without seeing what it is that you do. So whether it's using your friends and contacts or whether it's creating some pretend sales, then you need to do what you need to do to showcase your product. My next tip is related to customer service, and it is all about going the extra mile for your customers. So when I talk about that, I'm talking about replying really quickly to any query on social media or via email, and just being super friendly and basically getting a good rapport with people so that they want to spread the word about your business. And that's really it. You want to get the word out, have a positive vibe about your business. So customer service is definitely key. So we're going to go back a step now actually and talk about how to establish your business name. And this is a really, really important one. When you're coming up with your name, make sure it's something that people can spell. So you probably want to avoid coming up with something that's so ambiguous that people, like a foreign word or a made up word that people don't know how to type into Google, don't know how to search for, don't know how to talk to their friends about. So really try to avoid anything too obscure like that that makes you unsearchable. I will say also that for every one of these suggestions, there is an instance where it's worked well for somebody. So take these with a grain of salt. Think really carefully about what your business is and the ways that you may want to expand it in the future. And the reason this is important for your business name is that you don't want to pigeonhole your business too much if you're going to expand. So don't get too specific where you're offering a product that then doesn't fit into what your business name is. The reverse can actually be true. If you are sure that you're offering a business that is very specific, it can be very beneficial to have a specific sort of name so people know exactly what you're offering. For example, we have friends who, friend is a builder and he does house re-stumping, Tweed Valley house re-stumping. It's very clear what he does, and anyone who's looking for that service is going to go to his business because they know that he will be specializing in that thing. Another example, there's a shop nearby here, and I think the business is called Tummy Control Swimwear. Now, that's not a particularly enticing name, but in the demographic of this area in the mall where it's located, with a sort of older population, Tummy Control Swimwear, yes, that's gonna get the ladies who want that in that shop because they know that that's exactly what it sells. But if that business wanted to expand into other types of swimwear or whatever, then they're gonna miss out on that type of business because their name is too specific. So you just have to put time into thinking about how niche or how broad you want your business to go before naming it. It is a hassle to rebrand because it takes so long to set up logos and signatures and websites and all this stuff, and then you also sort of like lose your social media following from each of those things when you switch over. So you really want to try and get the company name right. Another thing, another tip with business names is to be really careful about using the location of your business in your business name or your logo. In some instances, it's perfectly okay to use your location if you're sure that you're going to be staying in that area, and if you're sure that your business is only serving that area, then sure, you can absolutely use your location name in your business name. But just be careful if you think you might want to move with your business or expand. You just need to be careful about using the location name in your business. A little hint, if you do want to use your location name in your business, is to build that name into your business in a way that can be adaptable later if you want to expand. So don't make the location name like the central part of your business or the central part of your logo. Make it so that if you do happen to change locations or do happen to want to expand, that you can actually change your tweak your logo or tweak your business name in a way that's not gonna like completely disrupt your business. Two quick little tips for business names as well are to make sure that your name is available. So you can go onto the state name register and obviously just type in the company name, see if it's available to use, and then register that name to make sure it's yours. That does cost money, but it gives you just peace of mind that you have the rights to that name. Another good idea is if you're starting out your business and you are fairly sure that you're going to have a website, is to reserve the domain name for that website to make sure that that is going to be yours and not taken by anyone else. And my final tip when it comes to business names is to get some feedback from your contacts or a group on Facebook or something like that before you commit to the name. So coming up with a business name is one of the hardest parts of starting the business, and you are going to want to get some feedback just in case. It might sound fine to you, but it might be really awkward and weird to other people. So it pays to just send your idea to a few people that whose opinion you trust, and just get their feedback if you are a little bit unsure about the name. Okay, so another little tip, keep your existing day job while you start the business. So unless your new job requires you to completely pour all of your energy into that business, I really do recommend starting on the side just to make sure that your business is viable and that you're not going to put yourself in a stressful situation. Unless of course you're out of work and you have all your eggs to throw into that new basket, then go right ahead. But it is probably a good idea to just test the waters before completely quitting your job and creating stress for yourself. So that just means putting in the hard yards before work, after work, on the weekends and that type of thing. And sort of to that same theme is to not sort of overinvest in a small business when you're just starting. So don't throw all your money into getting a really fancy web designer to make you the best website before you've even begun, before you've even seen if you enjoy the business or if you've seen that your business is viable in the market. So with a website, start with a free one. I like Wix. I find that really easy to use and they've got good templates and all of that stuff. My next tip is to ask for feedback and don't be afraid of feedback. Find a way to capture feedback from your customers and, you know, let them know I'm a new business and I would really appreciate if you gave me any feedback on my product or service, and then implement that feedback to improve your business. Another way that you can go about getting feedback, and this is a personal plug, my business Punchy, which I'll link below, offers a feedback service. So professional feedback where I test your product, I test your service, and I give you feedback. The benefit of using a third party like me to do that is that I'm going to be completely honest with you, whereas a customer or a friend or whatever may not be completely honest with you. And just with my background and experience, I can give you professional feedback that will help you improve your business. My other final tip is, even though I am saying don't try to be perfect when you start your new business, do try to be as professional as possible. If you are launching with a website, please get someone to proofread and proofread your website before you put it out there. You can get a trusted friend or someone living in your house to check this for you. That's a great place to start. But another good thing is to get an actual proofreader or editor to have a look at your website to make sure that there's no glaring errors, that there's no sloppy writing, and that what you're offering is clear. My business, Punchy, again, personal plug, I do a proofreading and editing of website content. I also offer a service where I test the user experience of your website. So this is where I land on your page, and this is based on my experience in communications, in graphic design and marketing, and as a proofreader. I give you professional feedback on what it's like as your customer to land on your page, to navigate through your page. I look at the info that's there, I look at how easy it is to move around, I look at info that's missing, I look at things that are really awkward, things that are sloppy, and I also give you actual corrections for the content of your website and the wording. I also look into the search engine optimization a little bit to get more visitors into your site. But you don't have to do that, just as long as you get someone to look at your website to make sure that it's correct. But if you use someone like me, you are going to get sort of a more, like a very careful look into what your communications look like. And the reason that this is important, the reason I'm so passionate about this, is that I know that when people look at your communications, they are judging you. If they go to your website or your Facebook page or what have you, and it's a sloppy and spelled incorrectly and just lack of care and whatever, it doesn't reflect well on you or your business, and they're probably more inclined to go with someone that looks a little bit more savvy. It does depend on the business, obviously, but I think it pays just to invest that little bit of time and effort into getting your business communications professional so that you can start off on the right foot. So that concludes my tips for starting a new business. I hope that you got something out of this, whether it was just one or two little tips. I hope that some of these tips can help you in your business ideas and ventures. And if you are starting a new business, I'd love to have a look at it. So pop me a comment or visit my my pages from the description box below, and I'd love to be in contact with you. So thank you again for watching, and good luck with your new business. I'll talk soon. Bye.